Welcome back to Steve Robb Reviews. Today's review is going to be a review for everyone. This is going to be all about this 120 volt compact like bar fridge. And I've got my meter up here, my amp clamp. We're going to do some electrical testing and we're going to compare this fridge to the fridge that I bought 2018, and I use it for off-grid. I use it on my power inverter, modified sine wave power inverter. And I'm going to talk about some things about fridges that maybe, well, you may find very fascinating. So we're going to go back to 2018 right now, and I'm going to show you the video I did of the previous fridge. If you take a look at this fridge right here, you could see it's about the same size, except the design is different. And I'm going to tell you right now, I'm the first one to admit, I bought the wrong fridge. You live and learn, right? So I've lived and learned for enough years to switch it over to the proper fridge. I'm going to explain why. But the first thing we got to do is do some electrical testing from back in 2018 and compare it to this one right here. So take a look at a small little video clip here, and I'll take this out of the packaging, get it all set up, and we're going to do some testing. This is the fridge here, and it's set at 4, and that's what it says you're supposed to leave it at. It's got like a nice little freezer here. I didn't even take the blue tape off yet, but yeah, it's a nice size, just over 3 cubic feet. I'm going to show you the inspection plate on the back and how much power this uses. Okay, here we go right here, and 0.79 amps at 115 volts AC. Okay, I got you all set up there. Let's just take a look and see what's going on here. All I'm going to do is just plug it in, and away we go. Okay, so what you're looking at there is a reading of 0.58 amps. And if you take a look on the right-hand side there where the arrow is, it shows millivolts AC. I'm using a Fluke amp clamp that converts millivolts AC into amperage. So you could see it's a little bit more than a half an amp running. And then now we go to the maximum amount of amperage on startup. And you could see it's just over 7 amps starting. The third one below is 0.64 is the average between running and starting amps. So that is within the specs on the back of the sheet. So let's see what the specs are for this one here. Okay, so here's the fridge right here. And the first thing you could notice, it's got a fridge on the bottom. I'll just open it up for you here. I'm going to open it up again in the future to show you something very interesting. But there is the fridge part. And this is 3.1 cubic feet, which is the total amount. And here is the freezer. You notice that this has got a freezer and the other one had one built in. Well, that is a huge problem. So let's go to the setup we got going on here. And I got my test equipment just sitting here getting calibrated. I'll have to reset it before I actually plug it in. But let's go to the back of the inspection plate and let's see exactly what the specs are on this. Okay, so here's the specs right here. As I expected, it's going to be higher because it has a separate freezer. This one here is showing 115 volts. At 60 hertz, and we're at 1.1 amps. So we're going to plug this in and we're going to test it, and we're going to see what the actual specs are in relation to this data spec sheet on the back. So when you're thinking about buying a fridge, you're not going to see no specs anywhere on the outside of the container. They're only going to be on the back. So is 1.1 amps any good or not? Well, let's plug it in. Let's find out. Okay, so the fridge just shut off about 30 seconds ago, and I noticed while it was running, I reset the menu here, and I noticed when it was running it had dropped down to 9.98. Well, it's just brand new, right? So it's got to break in a little bit. So it's running at about what they said, an amp, and these are the numbers here. So I started it up at 11:27. It shut off at 11:46, so that's 19 minutes that it ran. And You know, that's not bad at all because it's about consistent with the last fridge. Now, let's go take a look in the freezer and see what the temp is in the freezer, because I got a thermometer in there, and let's see what the temperature is. Okay, so there's the thermometer right there. And if we take a look there, you know, that is way too cold for what I need. I mean, that's like minus, well, it's almost at the end there in Celsius. That is like super cold. I don't need it that cold. So, gonna open the fridge here. Another thing I don't need is a light. I don't need a light in there. And another thing that you notice there, it's on number four. So yeah, number four, I don't need it to be that cold. So what I'm gonna do next is put the thermometer inside the, because this is cold. Let me just take a look at my temperature gun here and see. Yeah, look at that, like that is super cold. Who needs 24 degrees? That's Fahrenheit. 32 is freezing. I mean, that's a little too cold, right? So I'm gonna turn this down a bit and I'll bring you back and we'll do it again. But I'm gonna be testing this off and on so you can see it's from zero to the coldest is 7. 4, they say, is what it should be. I'm gonna probably turn it back a bit. So let's see what it shows here. I mean, with that light bulb being on, let's just reset it. Yeah, like it's hardly burning anything at all. So, you know, I'm not going to take the light bulb out. So what I'll do is I'm going to start the test over again, but I'm going to be doing stuff a little bit different and I'm going to explain to you why. But so far it's looking promising. Okay, so there's a shot of the compressor in the back there. And I'll tell you, this is the quietest fridge I've ever heard, because if I wasn't looking at the meter, I'd never know this thing would start or not. You know, when you're about 2 feet away, 3 feet away, you can't even hear this thing running. So let's take a look and see what the specs are now, because the fridge just started up after the 19 minute runtime. So let's take a look. Okay, so it's running still when it started up, just over 1 amp. And the startup, yeah, we're twice as what the last fridge was, it's almost. The last fridge was 7 amps. This is starting up 12.3. Now, it's going to get better over time as the compressor breaks in, but I found this very interesting. So if we go to the paperwork here, it ran for 19 minutes before it shut off, and it was off and just started up after 19 minutes. So this is what the specs are on my old fridge, my runtime. The old fridge would run for 9 minutes on and then off for 15 minutes. Now, I did open and close the fridge. I'm going to show you what I got going on there. And then let's take a look at that before I go any further. Okay, so here we are here. I turned it down to 3. And you know, when it goes into the green, that's supposed to be ideal for a fridge. And it was colder than minus 10 in the freezer before. So we'll let that stabilize. But I tell you something, I put some water in here, because the best thing you could do with one of these fridges, start it up with nothing inside and then put your contents in. Especially if you're off-grid like I am, using a power inverter. And if you don't, this fridge would run for like over an hour if you kind of filled it up and then first started it up. So that's what you got to do, is you got to put your contents in after the first cycle. So let me just talk a little bit about, see the controls there? That's a light. There's nothing in here that's digital. I had to make sure everything was analog with a manual thermostat. You don't want digital if you have a modified sine wave. So, you know, that's the main tip there, is if you're going to need a pure sine wave inverter, if you get one of these fridges that has any digital controls on it, because, well, they don't run good on a modified sine wave inverter, and you're going to pay 2 or 3 times the cost in changing your inverter. So I had to go with another one like this. And I like this fridge because it's got a crisper on the bottom like this. The other one didn't. It's got some nice pockets on the side that are more practical for me. And of course, it's got the freezer. So I'm gonna let this sit for a while and run at the 3 setting. And I'll bring you back with some interesting specifications. Okay, so the fridge just cycled on. I've been doing some testing. And I come out here almost at 11:30 in the morning, and well, the testing has completed, and I got some very interesting results. But I know a lot of you are going to know, okay, so what's the temperature in your shop? Let's go over to the thermometer. Let's take a look. Okay, so there's the temperature right there, and it's about, I would say, 75 degrees. Or 25? Yeah, I'm on the Fahrenheit. I don't bother with the Celsius stuff. But yeah, that's temperature out here. And in my experience, I've never really noticed much difference on runtime or off time with temperature. Not unless it's extreme, and I'm not dealing with any extremes. I would say the hottest it's ever gotten in my cabin is maybe 80 degrees. So, well, let's go take a look at the results and let's see what actually occurred. Okay, so you have to let a fridge stabilize for a while. 4 hours is ideal. This is less than 4 hours. But if we just take a look, 146, it went on. 157, it went off. So I'm saying the cycle time is about 10 to 11 minutes it stays on. And look at this, shocking. 220, it actually started up. I went 23 minutes with the fridge off. We take a look at the old specs. It was 9 minutes on, 15 minutes off. This is 10 to 11 minutes on time and 23 minutes off. So the duty cycle is huge on this compared to this one. So when you're taking a look at your the on time is what you got to really worry about when you're off grid and you're using your battery pack is although this machine runs at twice the amount of amperage, it's actually given me a better result in on off time. So if you take a look at your duty cycle, if it was like 1 minute on, 1 minute off, you know, that's a 50% duty cycle. So these results right here are pretty impressive. You know, like 10 minutes on and 23 minutes off, that's pretty efficient. So let's go over, let's take a look at the fridge. So I've had this ice cube sitting in there since 11:30, and still froze solid. Like, I mean, this is awesome. And I'm going to show you this ice pack right here. They freeze at a higher temperature than water. So water freezes at 32 degrees. These here will freeze, you know, better than water. And in my last fridge, well, total fail. Okay, so let's take a look at the fridge inside here. And there you go right there. I'm right in the bottom end of the green zone for a fridge. Water's nice and cold. And of course, it'll be colder in the crispers than it will be up here. So this is just awesome. And I have it set at 3. So let's just talk about my old fridge first. The one that you open up, and of course you could see that I have a much smaller refrigerator capacity now and a much larger freezer capacity. And that's exactly what I wanted, because I'm going to be taking these up in my cooler packs and I can put them in there and they will freeze solid. In the last fridge, nah, not a chance. I'll tell you what would happen. In them fridges that have that little compartment for a freezer inside there, that cools the whole fridge as well. It's different than this system here. And what would happen was I'd have to turn it to about 6. 7's the highest rating for the coldest temperature, I'd have to turn it to 6 to get something to freeze. And guess what was happening? I was getting ice in my water. It was getting way too cold. So I back it off a bit, and then what happens? Everything starts to melt in the freezer. So I mean, them type of refrigerators with the built-in freezer are not that great. I learned my lesson. I got to go with one like this, but of course it's going to burn a little bit more amperage. But with the cycle time of that fridge being off more than twice as much as it's on will make up for the extra amperage that the fridge is using. So really, when you take a look at it, if it was 10 minutes on, 10 minutes off, that would be like, well, the fridge is only on for 12 hours a day, right? But when you've got 10 minutes on and 20 minutes off, well, you're talking about maybe only 8 hours total runtime in a 24-hour period. So I think this is going to work out great. Now, for some context here, what I have is 4 6-volt batteries, like golf cart batteries. And I've got it wired up, so they're actually 2 12-volts. And that would be a capacity of 400 amps. I've got 4 100-watt solar panels. And on my old system, whenever I would wake up in the morning, I'd never see the battery level less than 12.4. And, you know, that's hardly drawing anything, really, when you think about it. And this year, as you're going to see, I'm going to increase my capacity on the solar panels. I'm adding 2 more solar panels. I'm going to be on the end of my cabin. But overall, this is the way to go. Not them fridges that's got the built-in freezer, because as far as I'm concerned, well, it's been pretty useless for me. So, like when I do put this ice pack in my fridge up there, it doesn't freeze solid. It just gets cold enough. So if I'm bringing something back with me, you know, from my camp, well, it just stays cool, but it doesn't freeze. Now, well, this opens up a whole new ball game for me, because now I can bring up frozen foods. And by the time I get up there, they're not completely thawed out. I can put them in the freezer, and Bob's your uncle. So thanks for joining me here today. I hope you found this informative. If you have any questions, go ahead. And if I have the answers, I'll do my best at answering. But, you know, when it comes down to it, there's a lot of math that goes into figuring out, you know, duty cycle and amperage and, you know, what's the capacity of your system. Because this here starting up at around 12 amps, you're going to need a power inverter that can provide, I would say, like a 15-amp circuit. And I have that no problem. I got 2 15-amp circuits, and that's plenty for me for my needs. So thanks for joining me here today. Come back again. If you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe and see some interesting things that you're probably not going to see somewhere else. Cheers.